What is going on, YouTube? Flopfish here, and welcome to the first episode of my Be a GM Fantasy Draft Series in NHL 13. And this is where I try to win the Stanley Cup using a completely fantasy draft team, and we're going to create a dynasty together. So first off, we need to find the team I'm going to use. I'm just randomizing the team list three times. Rangers are at the top, Lightning, Flyers. It's not bad. We're going to play on medium just because I found that I did a test run on hard and it just wasn't as good. And then the draft order is going to stay as we enter it here. I'm not going to random it like I did the other year because I was upset that I had like 15th pick. So we got 9. Not bad. So let's advance and let's start drafting here. So Crosby, Ovechkin, Stamkos, Price, Letang, Datsyuk, Malkin, Quick. Alright, let's see, who do we have? We have Taze and Giroux. Do we go with the cover boy? Kovalchuk's not bad either. Let's just take a look at goals quickly. I know it might not be bad. I want Schneider though. Defenseman. Any young blue liners. Ember, I guess. But we would be able to sneak him in the next round. Alright, so it looks like it's either Taze or Giroux. Taze is a little bit more of a two-way player. Let's pull this up quickly. Giroux's more of a dynamic offensive, I want to say. He's not the best at face-offs. He's center. Let's see. His offensive skills are way better. Like, his puck skills are insane. Taze is pretty good. He's pretty good overall, physical. Taze is a much better overall player. Giroux is much more dynamic. This is a top pick. But I think just because of salary and... You know what? I think we're going to have to go with... We're going to go with Giroux. We're taking the cover boy, and Taze went next. So it's kind of how we get to see things. Right, so let's just write this down here. Not that Petrangelo went 16th. So we got Giroux. And they went pretty high too. Just clicks in. Taylor Hall right before me. Logan Couture. Oh, Jamie Benn. A lot of the players I wanted to take got taken. Let's see. Let's just scroll here. Go through age. So we've got... We need someone to play the wing. I want a sniper preferably. Jeff Carter. That'd be bad. Jordan Staal might not be bad, actually. It's a good goalie. Where's Schneider at? No, there's lots of good goalies left, so I can take Rask even. Seabrook is defensive. Offensive, we can just get a guy later. I think we'll go after Ryan with you. Right winger, sweat this guy potential here. If there's anyone like Bobby Ryan. Bobby Ryan or Jordan Eberle. Eberle's a sniper, 84. Power forward though. I don't know, Bobby Ryan always seems good, but I think the 3 years younger, it's gonna help Eberle, so let's draft Eberle. Quick Sam. Wow, Lucic just went and Chara. Alright, and then left wing, Marlo is looking like a good pick here actually. Make sure there's no one with the potential down here. Mike Green, so Mike Green will be gone the next time I come around to pick. But no, I'm pretty comfortable taking Marlo, especially if we're going first year, just to win. So let's go ahead, we go with Gordon. You know what, there's lots of good centers, there's only one sniping left winger. we're going with Patty Marlowe. So our first line is looking pretty sharp, pretty offensive, pretty powerful. Ekman Larson just went, crap, that's who I wanted. Bollmeister might not be bad, but he's declining in potential. So Ryan Mitten, offensive defenseman, 85. His name is Giordano, actually. See if there's any potential still left. Keith Yandel is probably a good pick. Let's see who's left. We got Gardner. JVR might not be a bad pick, to be honest. So we have Yandel, Rimbaud, Jack Johnson. 25, he's a new member. Yep, we're going with Jack Johnson. Rob Mazzaros goes pretty high in these two. Former Vancouver Giant right there. Alright, so now let's look at who we've drafted. So we've got, we need a goalie. Did I forget? Wait, what? No, he got drafted. We're going to have to sign him in the offseason and trade for him. But let's just find a goalie with a decent potential. And a good overall. Yeah, we got lots of goalies left, so let's just find someone with some good... a decent D partner. Probably I'll probably take him a later round. Ryan Lipp is still there. Calamari might not be bad, but he's got a high salary. Let me see, he's a sniper. You put him on the line. Do we take the all-star? Buffy Lethal? It's kind of seeing who's on the depth chart as far as like potential and stuff. Jeff Schwartz is still, he's still got potential. Yandel, I think Yandel's going to be a good pick. Alright, that's it for someone around. So we need a goal before we get too carried away here. Not Niemi, not Thomas. Kiprasov's looking like our best bet. Right now, it might not be Bernie. I could see that. Alright, we're taking Bernie. It's not bad. Not a bad pick there, actually. Draft player. Canucks got Sedoguchi off. They had number one pick. Alright, so now we're going to need a stay-at-home defenseman or someone, a second center. I like to build my team from the center out, so we've got some good people still later on. Weiss will be a good pick. Fisher's a good pick, so Ribeiro's just dirty. Alright, so we don't really have to worry about centers too much then. Now let's go with... find someone decently young. Just got a decently low salary. 29 defensive defenseman, 4 million, he's not bad. So Gleason, Fleischmann's dirty in the scheme. I might have to take Fleischmann. I don't see anyone else down here. Burrows. How many years since he had left on this deal? 1 year left? We'll be around next time. I think he might be around. If not, I'll pick up Ryan Cole. So I think we're going to go with Fleischmann. I think he's my best bet here. We're going with Fleischmann. Burrows is probably gone.